Morning, everyone. This is Grace's Classy Cuts Oasis, 14100 Kent Street. We are a hair and barber shop. We do have a lot of natural or homemade products that we sell in the shop, supporting other people here in Red Deer, Alberta. In addition to that, we have lashes, tanning, manicures, and pedicures as well. Today on our video, we're going to talk about the four different steps to continuing on your path and not get off of it. So I've written a little bit down. If you see me looking down, I'm sorry, guys. Today, I didn't have everything memorized. Alrighty. Step one is to find yourself and connect with yourself. Find your own truth and your inner self, not what other people say about you. So the definition, I guess, would be to explain it like this. Some people think I'm ugly, but I decide differently, right? Some people may not like who I am, but I can decide differently for myself who I am, not what other people are saying or putting on me. So you need to start doing that with yourself. The second step is going to be reminding yourself and welcoming who you truly are and who you've decided that you are repetitively. For me, I have to do it daily. It used to be a lot more, but now it's just that quick reminder, you know what? I am beautiful. I am talented. I am loving. I build others. And looking always into my own eyes, into my spirit, so that my inner self really receives that. And then nextly, we're going to start deciding where I'm going to take myself, where I'm going to take my life. I'm not going to allow this journey to be controlled by outward sources any longer. So I'm deciding that I'm mentoring. I'm deciding that I'm going to lose the extra weight that I have. I'm deciding that my passion in life is going to build others, so building others. So it's not just that that's my passion anymore. It's something that I do. Right? These are all decisions I'm making for my own life. That way I can walk forward into those decisions with a definite path that I've decided to take. And then, of course, the fourth one is to disengage my fear. Disengage my fear and the anger that comes along with fear. So that fear example for the weight one is going to be the fear of not being able to lose the weight fast enough, or not being able to stay committed, or not being able to lose that weight for some reason, right? So if I just keep on focusing on that fear, I'm not losing any weight, I'm not being able to be steady in my workout, etc., etc., then what happens is I create that path for myself of not being consistent and not losing it. And that frustration just becomes a vortex cycle that continues. So instead, I'm going to train myself to remind myself, you know what? I am being as consistent as I can be. I am trying my best. I am on my way to losing that weight or whatever path I've chosen for myself. So taking these four steps, you can use in different paths in your life, obviously. I'm just using this weight one and this mentoring as examples, right? So write it out. Try it for a little while. Send out some verbal affirmations and see what comes back. It works pretty good. All right, guys, have a really good week. I can't wait to see you in the shop. Bye.